Once again, good morning, students. We are reading the chapter, The Great Stone Face, part 2. So we know there is a mountain which resembles a face, and there is a prophecy that one day somebody will be born in the valley and will grow up to resemble the great stone face. So first there was gather gold, which everybody believed that resembled the great stone face. However, Ernest does not agree. The years went on and Ernest grew up to be a young man. He attracted little notice because he was a simple man from the inhabitants of the valley. They saw nothing remarkable, nothing wonderful, nothing amazing about his way of life, except that when the labor of the day was over, he still loved to gaze upon the great stone face, which he has been doing since his childhood. Their idea was that this was a folly, and they thought that this was a false idea to keep on gazing at the great stone face. But pardonable, it could be excused. Because why? Because Ernest was hardworking, industrious, kind, and neighborly. Neighborly is friendly. They did not know that the great stone face had become a teacher to him, and that is why he gazed for hours, and that the sentiment which was expressed in it would enlarge the young man's heart. And he had become young man's heart, that is, enlarges, increase. That is not the size. What it means is that his heart was more kind, more generous, more friendly, and fill it with deeper sympathies. Sympathies is pity, than other hearts. So he was more pitiful, had more sympathies towards others than other people. They did not know that from this would come a better wisdom than could be learned from books. And they did not know that he was learning a lot from this great stone face, which he could not have learned from books. Neither did Ernest know that the thoughts which came to him so, and even Ernest did not know that whatever ideas, thoughts came to his mind naturally, were from the fields and at the fireside, were of higher tone than those which all men shared with him. So his ideas, his thoughts were more wiser, he was more wiser, and they came naturally to him without even having a teacher, without even reading books. A simple soul, simple as when his mother first told him the old story, that is the old prophecy. He beheld, that is, looked at the marvelous face looking down the valley and still wondered why its human life was so long in coming. And he's still wondering why somebody is still not born who resembles the great mountain face. By this time, poor Mr. Gathergold, so he was rich, now he's become poor, was dead and buried. His wealth, which was the body and spirit of his existence. Here it means that he was known only for his wealth. Otherwise, if you go back, you'll see that he was shrewd. He was unkind, he had yellow face. By this time, Mr. Gathergold was dead and buried. His health, his wealth, which was the body and spirit of his existence, had disappeared before his death. So now he was a poor man, he died a poor man. Since the melting away of his gold, that is when his wealth had gone, it had been generally agreed that there was no great likeness, and everybody started believing that this person, Gathergold, had no resemblance to the great stone face. That is the ruined merchant, that is Gathergold, and the majestic face, that is the mountain. Excuse me. It so happened that another son of the valley had become a soldier many years before. So there is another person now, another character. After a great deal of hard fighting, he is now a famous commander. So he was a soldier who has become a commander after fighting great fights, wars. He was known on the battlefield by the name of Blood and Thunder. This is his nickname. Old and tired now, he is retired. He's old. He had lately expressed a desire to return to his valley. The inhabitants, his old neighbors and their grown-up children prepared to welcome the renowned, famous. Renowned is famous commander. It was being said that at last the likeness of the great face, stone face, had actually appeared. And now again, once again, people started believing that someone from the valley was born who had the likeness of the great stone face. Great, therefore, was the excitement throughout the valley, and many people who had never once thought of glancing is looking for a short while at the great stone face, now spent much time in gazing at it. So So now they wanted to see, they were looking at the mountain, so they want to see whether this person, soldier, commander, Blood and Thunder resembled the great stone face. On the day of the general's arrival, Ernest and all of the people in the valley left their work. See, they're welcoming the general and proceeded to the spot place where a great banquet is a welcome party, had been prepared. Soldiers stood on guards because he's the commander now. Flags waved and the crowd roared. Roared is welcome, shouted. Ernest was standing too far back to see Blood and Thunder's face. So he was also in the crowd, but he could not see the face of the general. However, he could hear several voices, but he could hear people talking in the crowd. It's the same face, exactly, cried one man, dancing for joy. Bilkul same hai. Wonderful. Like it, that's a fact, replied another. Another also agreed with him. And third person, and why not, cried a third. He's the greatest man of this or any other age, beyond a doubt. And everybody in the crowd is agreeing that he resembles the great stone face. Ernest at last could see the general's face, and in the same glance to the side, he could also see the great stone face. So you can see there, he is looking at the face of the general, and at the same time, behind him is looking at the mountain face. He could also see the great stone face. If there was such a likeness as the crowd proclaimed is announced, declared, Ernest could not recognize it. Once again, whatever the crowd, whatever the people were saying, that he resembles the great stone face, Ernest does not agree. He could not find any resemblance. Fear not, Ernest, said his heart. And once again, his mind is saying, as if the great stone face was whispering to him, fear not, Ernest, he will come. And once again, as far as Ernest is concerned, he doesn't find any likeness, any resemblance of the general commander to the great stone face. So that's the end of this first chapter of this great stone face. We'll continue it in our next video. Thank you all of you and have a nice day.